This stock looks cheap, undervalued even. Your model confirms it, the signal is clear, it's time to act. You could buy the stock. If it goes up $1, you make $1. If it falls $1, you lose $1. A direct one-to-one relationship, but buying 100 shares ties up a lot of capital. You want the same potential upside with less money up front. In other words, you want leverage. So you buy a call option instead. Now the stock ticks up by $1. What happens to the option's price? Maybe it rises by 50 cents, maybe 80. The exact amount is measured by delta. Delta is the first and most fundamental of the Greeks. It measures how much an option's price is expected to change for every $1 move in the underlying stock's price. Think of it as the speedometer for your option's directional exposure. If you have a call option with a delta of 0.65, it means for every $1 the stock goes up, the option's price will go up by about 65 cents. If the stock drops $1, the option's price will drop by about 65 cents. This isn't a guess, it's math, and the market takes it seriously. This deep dive into Delta is a sneak preview of our stock options course available for purchase on Socratica.com. Our course will teach you all about the fundamentals of stock options, including payoff diagrams, volatility, trading strategies, and more. You know you'll learn more with Socratica. Follow the link below. In the language of calculus, delta is the first order partial derivative of the option's value, V, with respect to the stock's price, S. This formula simply isolates the effect of the stock price on the option's price, assuming all other variables like time and volatility remain constant. Why does this relationship exist? Because an option's value is fundamentally linked to the difference between the stock price and the strike price. As the stock moves, it changes the probability of the option finishing in the money, and it changes the potential size of that payoff. Delta is the single number that quantifies this sensitivity. Let's first explore delta for call options. We'll start at the extremes and then meet in the middle. First, consider a call that's way out of the money. The stock price is so far below the strike that there's virtually no chance the option will be worth anything at expiration. If the stock goes up a dollar, that's not enough to make a worthless option suddenly valuable. It was basically worth zero before. It's basically worth zero after. So the delta is about zero. Now let's jump to the other extreme, a call that's deep in the money. Here, the option is almost certain to be exercised. If the stock goes up $1, the option's intrinsic value increases by exactly that dollar. In other words, its delta is about one. And now let's meet in the middle at the money call. Here, the option is right on the edge. It's like a coin toss, whether it will end up in the money or out of the money. That 50-50 probability of finishing in the money translates into a delta of about 0.5. In other words, a $1 move in the stock leads to about a 50-cent move in the option's price. Another way to interpret this is that each incremental move in the stock is equally likely to push the option further into the money or out of it, resulting in a delta of about 0.5. This is where many people can get confused, so we're going to offer another way of looking at this situation. Think of this at-the-money middle situation in terms of exposure. A deep-in-the-money call is 100% exposed to the stock's moves. It is the stock. A far-out-of-the-money call is 0% exposed. It's just cash. Right here at the money, that coin toss means the option is perfectly balanced. It's only half exposed to the stock's risk. That 50% exposure is the 0.5 delta. It means a $1 move in the stock leads to about a 50-cent move in the option's price. So to recap, for a call option, delta ranges from 0 when it's far out of the money to 1 when it's deep in the money, and about 0.5 right at the money. Put options work the same way, but in reverse. Their deltas range from negative 1 to 0. A negative delta means the option's price moves in the opposite direction of the stock. Here's a far out of the money put. The stock price is way above the strike. This put is almost worthless, and a $1 move in the stock price doesn't change that. Its delta is near zero. Now look at this deep in the money put. The stock price is way below the strike. This option is almost certain to be exercised and is moving one for one inversely with the stock. If the stock drops $1, the put's value gains almost $1. Its delta is approaching negative one. And an at-the-money put option? Just like for the call, it's highly sensitive with a delta around minus 0.5. A $1 up move in the stock causes a 50 cent drop in the put's price. Now let's put it all together and talk about delta as more than just a sensitivity measure. For call options, delta ranges from 0 to 1. This may remind you how probabilities written in decimal form also vary from 0 to 1. This is more than a coincidence. There's an underlying mathematical reason for this. In addition to being a derivative, delta is also an approximation of the probability that an option will finish in the money. Let's see this from our previous examples. If a call is far out of the money, delta is about 0, which corresponds to about a 0% chance of finishing in the money. If it's deep in the money, delta is near 1, roughly a 100% chance. At the money, delta is about 0.5, a 50-50 shot. And now for puts. Put deltas run from 0 to negative 1. Because probabilities aren't negative, we take the absolute value. A far out of the money put has a delta near 0, about a 0% chance of finishing in the money. A deep in the money put has a delta near minus 1, whose absolute value is 1, roughly a 100% chance. At the money, the absolute value of delta is about 0.5, about a 50% probability. This isn't just a convenient rule of thumb. It's grounded in the math of option pricing. If you examined thousands of options, you'd find that delta closely matches the fraction that actually finish in the money. That's why quants treat delta not just as a measure of sensitivity, but as a fast, reliable proxy for probability. Let's see how you might use delta in practice. You own a call option worth $7.50 with a delta of 0.7. The underlying stock rises by 80 cents. What's the expected change in your option's price? We just multiply. Your call option should increase by about 56 cents, bringing its estimated value to roughly $8.06. Now you're holding a put option worth $4 with a delta of negative 0.35. The stock price drops by $1.15, a negative move. Multiply, the two negatives make a positive. Your put should rise by about 40 cents, for an estimated new value of around $4.40. Earlier, we compared delta to a speedometer. It describes an option's sensitivity to the underlying stock price at this very second. But what happens if the market hits the gas? As the stock price moves, your delta also changes. That 0.5 delta won't stay 0.5 for very long. As the stock rises, your delta might climb to 0.6, then 0.7. This raises a new question. How do we measure the rate of change of delta itself? How do we measure this acceleration? For that, we need to meet the next Greek in our cast, gamma. You'll find gamma and all the rest of the Greeks in our course on stock options. It's easy to sign up. Just follow the link below. It's going to be a little more work to actually take the course.